as K. Gandhi.
Well, whoever you are, we don't want you here.
Swim it, and he does. Ball comes loose, and the Bears have to get out of bounds. Rodgers along the sideline, another one. They're still in deep trouble at midfield. They tried to do a couple of... The ball is still loose as they get it to Rodgers. They give it back now to the 30. They're down to the 20. All the band is out on the field. He's going to go into the end zone. He's going to go into the Bears. The Bears have won.
It's hard for me to say I'm sorry. Hey folks, Crazy Climber 80 here again. And this time we're going to look at game number 10 in our 20 from 1982 series. Hope you enjoyed the new intro. But this was a famous vertically scrolling shooter created by Namco and licensed to Atari in the U.S. And it is called Xevious. And it was the first game that I know of to have a bomb-the-ground targets system in a overhead scrolling shooter, and you control a ship called the Solvalou, and you use a 8-way joystick to move the ship around, and you have a fire button and a bomb button, and you have a little crosshair sight, and whenever you press the bomb button, the bombs will fire into that crosshair sight, or where the crosshairs were at the time that you pressed the bomb button. This proved very, very, very popular. This was created at the tail end of 1982. It might have been generally released in arcades in 1983, but there's some cool hidden tricks in this game, and it's sometimes frustrating because they don't always work out the way that you want them to. Or maybe sometimes it seems criteria needs to have been met. You needed to shoot a certain amount of enemies, or certain types of enemies, or face certain types of enemies. I don't know. But this game is still really cool for its time. Those are the usual fodders of enemies, those rings, but there will be a bunch of different types of enemies. There's a whole enemy list of different types of enemies, both flying enemies and ground enemies, that you'll encounter in this game. Some of them will shoot, some of them will not shoot, and there will also be a boss fight, and it is called the ANDOR GENESIS, and we'll see that later. Yeah, your ship is named the Solvalou. So yeah, with one button you fire straight ahead, you have little double shots. You fire straight ahead, and then you have your crosshairs, and when you press the bomb button, there will be a bomb fired right where the crosshair was at the moment. So sometimes you'll need to shoot or a bomb ahead or in front of certain where certain moving enemies might be, because there will be mobile ground enemies. I first saw this probably at an arcade in Tigard, Oregon that was called Astrocade, and it was not there very long. But this was very popular. It has kind of repetitive music, but good sound effects. And the bomb ground targets motif would be copied by a litany of vertically scrolling shoot 'em ups. But this was truly a pioneer for those games. There are various ground targets that will shoot at you, and you will see them open a little mouth or something to fire a bullet at you. Some enemies will just shoot one shot, some enemies will shoot a lot of shots. And there's these crystal-like things that sometimes appear, and they kind of rain down on you. There's a name for every one of these enemies. There is the 1-up flag, the special flag from Rally X that gives you an extra life. That is hidden in various places. I will show you a map later on where at least most of those things are. There's not only the special flag, which gives you an extra life, but there are also hidden towers, which are 2,000 points to uncover and 2,000 points to destroy. We will look at those later, too. I was not really good at this game. Now we have these floating balls that are indestructible. A lot of interesting little enemies thrown into this game. Those pyramid-type ground targets, they are harmless. Those round ground targets, they will try to shoot at you. Some of the enemies will try to shoot at you from behind if they get past you, so watch out for that. There are there is a reference to, I believe, the Nazca lines in Peru in this game. And that Phoenix might be part of the Nazca lines. There's no end to this game. And you get an extra life at like 20,000 and 60,000. After that, I'm not sure. But, there is not even a breather. The game just does not stop. You keep on going. Even after you beat the boss, the ANDOR GENESIS, which is a giant floating fortress that you have to shoot either in the center, or you can take out its four cannons to make the fight a little bit easier. Even after you beat him, you don't get a break. And here he comes. He's got all these little bowling balls that come after you and shoot you. It's very tough, but again, if you get one shot right at his center, and you have to kind of fire it ahead of him, a bomb, to destroy him. When you die, you get put just back a little from where you left off. Like I said, there are some enemies that like to shoot you from behind if they get past you. And some enemies can only shoot one bullet at a time, some enemies don't shoot at all, some enemies shoot a lot. I don't like those spinner guys. When you get one floating wall, then that usually means that the ANDOR GENESIS is coming. Can I get a bomb in? There we go. But yeah, it's got four little sensors at diagonal directions from the center area where you can bomb, and you can take those sensors out to give it less firepower. Ah, crap. Yeah, it gets a little tough to dodge some of those bullets, but you get to use, like, two-thirds, just about, of the playfield to move about. And the Solvalou is a little more nimble than you might think in trying to avoid enemy bullets. And you can push forward and pull back. And you move a little slower, it seems, perhaps, when you pull back than when you're moving forward. Maybe it's just me. Maybe not. But I enjoy this game. I still play it every once in a while, just trying to remember where those hidden special 1-up flags are, or where these hidden towers are that are called Soul Citadels, where those are. And again, we'll look at a map that shows where at least most of these hidden Soul Citadels and flags are. Anytime you see a glowing red or an opening hole in the ground targets, that means they're gonna fire. But they, the ground targets usually only shoot like one shot at a time unless it's a large tower. And again, those pyramids don't fire at all. There will be some ground targets that I guess if you bomb them, they might make less enemies appear in the near future. You only need to shoot down the middle or drop a bomb down the middle. See those tanks? Those are Grobda. And Grobda got its own game by Namco in 1984. Oops, dang it. I can't really do a whole lot better than 70,000 usually on this game. Yeah, you cannot destroy those floating walls or whatever they are. All these enemies in this game have weird names. The walls are called Bakura or something. And the ANDOR GENESIS for the boss. A lot of weird names. But like I was saying earlier, the moving ground targets, they will usually shoot at you. You have to put a bomb ahead of them where they're going to be able to take them out. Yeah, I think I was able to uncover one or two Sol Citadels in this game during this gameplay, but I was unable to completely bomb it once it appears. You have to bomb it to make it appear, you know, bomb where it's gonna appear, and then bomb it again. And I think you get 2,000 points for each task. So a total of 4,000, which is very nice. Yeah, like I said, the only extra lives I know of are at 2,000 and... Or at 2,000, that'd be nice. 20,000 and 60,000. And you get, of course, an extra life if you uncover one of the 1-up flags. And we'll see a little map that I downloaded off the internet that shows a lot of the flags and a lot of the Sol Citadel towers. There's at least one-up flag at the dead ends, at least one of the dead ends by the river there. Yeah, even those little crystal things have a name. I like the music here where you put in your initials. I don't think you can put in lowercase initials unless you maybe hold down the bomb button. I can't remember for sure, but I just put in RUS and said screw it, and just, you get to put in more initials than that, but I just said screw it and just went with RUS. But that's Xevious by Namco and licensed to Atari in 1982. Very cool, influential, vertically scrolling shoot 'em up. Influential largely because it introduced the bombing of ground targets with the bomb button, as far as I'm aware of. Some people think that this might be the first game to have cameo characters from earlier games, but it's not. Now here's a trick that gives you a special message if you bomb a certain dark spot coming up. It'll say Namco Original Program by Iwzu, and you get 10 points, and Iwzu is Masanobu Endo. And now we're going to bomb a Sol Citadel. I have invincibility on real right here. It's coming up, the first Sol Citadel. It'll be right before you see the first Grobdas. Right there. And then a little bit later, we've got our first one-up flag. Maybe. Sometimes it appears, sometimes it doesn't. Be a bomb right there on the river. There it is. Ta-da! And here is the map I promised you. Now, it's kind of hard to see. I'm going to scroll upwards very slowly in a minute. But if you see the Sol Citadels, they are little circular towers that have a long shadow hanging southeast of it. And really hard to see are the yellow special flags that give you a one-up if you bomb them and then touch them. This is kind of a general map. We're going to scroll upwards very slowly. But to the right, you can see where we bombed the first Sol Citadel, just southeast of where the Grabda tanks first appear. And then, of course, north of that, we're going to see the 1-up flag. This doesn't all show at once, but you will see portions of the west side of the map later on in the game. And we already saw basically the general enemies that you see in the general areas you see, except for this one enemy. It's not even an enemy. It's kind of dumb. It's like a couple diamonds that appear next to you, and they do nothing. That's kind of dumb. It's like they didn't finish that part of the game. They were meant to do something else, but it never came to fruition. But this is the map that shows the Sol Citadels and 1-up flags that I know of. And again, the Sol Citadels have a shadow that hangs to the southeast. That's how you can see them on the map. But that was Xevious. And again, Grabda, the Grabda tanks appear in this and have their own game called Grabda. But that's Xevious, game number 10 in our 20 from 1982 series. Hope you enjoyed, and I hope you join me soon with game number 9. Y'all stay cool and stay safe, everybody. I will see you later with game number 9 in my 20 from 1982 series. Y'all take it easy, everybody. Bye-bye.